Thank you, sir, once again. Now we move on to the very important session to honoring Dr. S. Sanmosundaram, sir. Because from my perspective, I want to say a few words. When I was a student in Stanley Medical College, MS postgraduate student in 1990 to 1993, at the time, Dr. Sanmosundaram was there. He was an assistant professor in cardiology department. We used to call him fondly a triple S, sir. Triple S, we used to call him. At the time, he was an AP in cardiology department under the guidance of Dr. Sivarajan, sir. When we were posted in Stanley Medical College cardiology department, he used to teach us very politely, calmly, the ECG, basics of ECG. Because everybody thinks that the surgeons doesn't know the ECG and doesn't know the stent. But because he used to teach us the basics of ECG. And we were very fortunate at that time. And sir is a very soft and polite, so tender. Not only in thoughts, and also in behavior and even writing. When you see his prescription will be rhythmic, regular, without any arrhythmia. Because usually the doctor's handwriting will be arrhythmic and more of ventricular tachycardia, supraventricular tachycardia. It's unable to read the doctor's prescription. Unlike others' prescription, SAR, triple SAR prescription is a standing example of how doctors should write. Is a regular and rhythmic. Used to write, I remember, the only the black ink, very small, and a thyroid patient ECG. You know, if you read thyroid patient ECG, like a monotonous, like small, I mean, wave pattern, like this is writing will be there, very nice. Even I used to keep, because my wife, family doctor, Dr. Triples, so that we used to keep all his prescription in my cupboard. I welcome you, sir. It's a great honor to be with you at this moment. Now, I call upon Dr. Elilarsan. Professor Elilarsan is a mentor, a past president, and great orator. And I welcome Dr. Elilarsan to honor Dr. Sanmosundaram, Triple S, sir, and also to give felicitation to Dr. Triple S, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Bhumati. It's a great pleasure. It's a great pleasure to be present when Professor Sanmosundaram is getting honored. Professor Sanmosundaram, as you said, he was doing his DM, or he was in cardiology when I was doing my house internship, right? And all Stanleyans, all of us in Stanley, we will know the picture. Even if you close your eyes, you can remember Dr. Sivarajan, Dr. Sanmosundaram, Dr. Sivakadaksham. All the three standing. It's like, you know, Shivakumar, Karthik, and three actors. You know, very youthful all the time. Even today, Dr. Sanmosundaram looks like as young as he was at that point of time. As you rightly said, very soft-spoken. And they taught us about writing a prescription legibly. I used to get, you know, this with a pen. Dr. Sivarajan used to hit us on the head. If you don't fill, when you fill up the case sheet, the number also, when you put, you know, the number should hit this this left corner of this column, and the right corner of the column should, the number should be written fully. Therefore, nobody writes in between. So it has become a habit from then. So it's such a kind of training. I don't know whether we have, our children have that kind of teachers. Professor Sanmosundaram is a great teacher. Very, very, very soft spoken. I've never seen a person who is with such knowledge and such experience and such wisdom to be so soft and so polite and so very humble. It is very difficult to see such people today. And I take this pleasure to read out the plaque on behalf of President Dr. Subramaniam. Dr. Subramani is he requested me to read it out, you know, as he is he's still recuperating from his uncle's demise. So I take this opportunity to present this award, lifetime Achievement Award on this date, the 28th June 2020, this citation is awarded to Dr. S. Shanmugasundaram for his outstanding contribution to society in the field of medicine. A medical graduate from Thanjavur Medical College, 1977 batch, was awarded MD General Medicine from Stanley Medical College and DM Cardiology from Madras Medical College in the year 1980 and in 1990, respectively. An emeritus professor of Tamil Nadu Medical University, is a senior consultant in cardiology at Bilroth Hospital, Chennai. He has served over 26 years in Government of Tamil Nadu Medical Services as a professor of cardiology at Stanley Medical College, professor of Madras Medical College, Meenakshi Medical College, Kanchipuram. He is also founder and trustee of SHAD, a charitable trust, and ASSERT, which is its full form I'm fortunate to be aware of. It's an Association of Cardiology Education, Research and Training, a teaching and a research association in cardiology that conducts regular health awareness and disease detection camps at Shivananda Charitable Trust, and also maintains an e-library at Gurumurthy School, Mayiladuthurai. A life member of IAOE, ICOC, CSOI, and IMA Kodambakkam branch. We are extremely proud to have him as our branch member. I joined with Dr. Subramani as president, and members of the Indian Medical Association, Chennai Kodambakkam branch, feel extremely proud to honor a doyen in the field of medicine, in the medical field. Sir, we take immense pleasure in offering this award to you, sir. Dr. Shanmugasundaram.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I request anyone who would want to join to say a few words, because we have no garlanding and things like that because of the Zoom.
I request all the members to give a big round of applause for honoring Dr. Shanmugasundaram, sir.
Thank you.
Professor Shanmugam, sir. Professor Shanmugasundaram, sir, can you speak?
Yeah, it's your turn, Triple S, sir, to give some words, sir.
Can I have a...
Somebody wants to speak.
Dr.
Lakshmi Narayan has to unmute himself because I had unmuted everybody and then muted everybody. So, yes, sir, Dr. Lakshmi Narayan.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible. Please go ahead.
Yeah. When I was asking to Dr. Umar in Stanley Hospital, Dr. Shanmugasundaram was our PG. He was a very unassuming personality. When he conducted the exam, he came first in all the exams. And he got the best outgoing student of in MD General Medicine. So I'm very happy that he has been awarded from IMA, the best doctor. Thank you, Dr. Shanmugasundaram. I wish you all success.
Thank you.
Yeah. Bhupati, you are unmuted. You are muted, please.
Yeah.
You have to unmute.
Yes, sir. Now it's okay. Sir, over to Dr. Shanmugasundaram, sir, to say a few words.
Thank you for the nice words. Good evening, dear friends. I'm really overwhelmed with your decision of choosing me for this prestigious honor to me. At the outset, I would like to pay homage to Dr. Chandrasekhar, who happened to be my first teacher in clinical medicine. third year clinical medicine posting. First posting is medicine. First day, my first teacher was Dr. Chandrasekhar. Yes, not only taught medicine, but yes, also motivated me to assume and adopt some important responsibilities in professional societies and organizations. In nutshell, he has taught me medicine as well as some politics, but good politics, not bad politics. The only way to pay tribute to him is remember him forever and adopt his good qualities and deeds. I know very well the way in which he had done for our organization, Kodambakkam IMA branch. Some of the meetings I have addressed in IMA Kodambakkam branch, how active he used to be, I still have it vividly in my mind. When I got a call from Dr. Edilarasan a week ago about the Kodambakkam branch's decision of giving me this title, I had mixed feelings. Some happiness, some pride, gratitude, humility, the remaining additional responsibility, as well as a little bit of a guilt feeling. The guilt feeling is mainly because that I have not been very actively participating in our branch meetings. I realize whatever specialty you choose and practice, we all feel that we should originally belong to IMA. When I am offered this award, in spite of this lacuna, I understand what an amount of affection and respect you all have in me. I bow my head and accept your love and recognition. At this moment, I should recall an instance. At the time, I was an assistant professor of cardiology in Stanley. One of the medicine professors was retiring on one day. The hall was full. Everyone, felicitated him very aptly. But, at the end, when he was supposed to reciprocate our felicitations, surprise, he started off with a sentence that I have never been, very successful, and I had not contributed anything to medicine as well as to the society. But it was not just words of humility. He really meant it. But we are all surprised because, he was a very lovable teacher, very noble human being overall. What else one should require to climb as achievements? I think none of us should develop such a feeling at any moment of our life. Each one of us is bestowed with responsibilities and duties. All of us do perform it sincerely. I think the feeling of achievement has to come from within yourself before your friends or the society recognize you. In that way, I'm fully satisfied that I could discharge my duties, and I continue to do that quite sincerely as a physician, as a teacher, as a friend, as a son to my parents, as a husband to my wife, as a father to both of my sons, and as a man in the society. I'm sure that most of us, if not all, do this every day, and every one of us can climb as achiever by that way. I hail from an agriculturalist family, a typical middle-class family from Tanjore. Went through a joyous but responsible undergraduate days, little difficult but still enjoyable days during my MD, and much more difficult period in the next decade when I entered government service. It took a very long time for me to stabilize, for which I have never felt bad, never repented. I have a feeling that it is the sum of success, sum of difficulties, failures, some motivation from your teachers and seniors, some hatred and jealousy of your own colleagues that makes you a perfect man. In that way, I had been very fortunate to go through everything, like, you know, both successes, both failure, as well as failures, all difficulties I could go through. Now I realize that I'm appreciated today. It's definitely not because of my intelligence, but because of my hard work and truthfulness. I can swear that hard work never hurts, but and never kills us. If I'm recognized today, it is not because of my successes, but it is all because of the combined effort of so many people around me. First, my parents, who had allowed me to choose this type of education I wanted. The amount of difficulties they went through, particularly when I finished my medicine and joined the postgraduate degree. Then, you know, the big list of great teachers with whom I was associated, Dr. M. Krishnasamy in Tanjavur, Dr. U. Muhammad, his assistant professors, Dr. Venugopal, Dr. Lakshmi Narayan. I'm glad to see him today. Dr. Imityas Bey, Dr. Rajnikant, and lastly, but mostly, my cardiology, chief, Dr. Sivaraj. My supportive family, who accepted my limited availability at home. Most of the days, I used to come home only to sleep. My encouraging friends and colleagues, my faithful students from whom I have learned more than I have learned from my teachers, and above all, my patients who had trusted me and who had adjusted with my hard working hours, whether it is midnight or early morning, 1 a.m., 1:30 a.m., or when I changed my practice times from morning till only evening, they adapted to my working hours and adapted to my disorganized pattern of working now and then. I thank every one of them. I thank all the members and the EC of IMA Kodambakkam who had chosen me to have this title, which I remember throughout my life. I wish that every one of you should become an achiever and be successful in life, and above all, lead a contented, joyous, and peaceful life. I think that's most important for all of us. I wish all of you to develop and shape up the art of mindfulness. Mindfulness is innate for all of us. Only thing is, we should, develop it better. I finish by saying that if you believe in yourself and if you are doing your duties, irrespective of the rewards which are coming in return, you are also an achiever. Best wishes and thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Very kind words.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.